A person of mass 3M is standing on the left edge of a long, uniform board of mass M and length L that is floating in water, as shown in the figure above. The person walks slowly to the right edge of the board. The water exerts no drag forces on the board. The position of the center of mass of the board when the person is at the right edge of the board is? The most important question we may ask ourselves on systems like the one being described here is, are there external forces doing work on the system? The reason this is important is the fact that the net external force being exerted on the system is the only factor that will affect the motion of the center of mass. If the system does not have external forces doing work, then the center of mass will have a constant state of motion. If the center of mass is at rest, it will remain at rest. Therefore, the position of the center of mass at the end of the process will be the same as it is at the beginning. In this case, it is safe to assume that the only forces external to the system are the gravitational force downward and the buoyancy force exerted by the water upward. These forces are perpendicular to the motion, so they are not doing any work. The system then is isolated, and the center of mass will remain at rest. The position is given by 3m times 0 plus m times L over 2, the geometric center of the board, divided by 4m. This is equal to L over 8. However, this is only the position of the center of mass of the system. If we wish to calculate the position of the center of mass of the board, we must consider that both the board and the person are showing some displacement. If XP represents the final position of the person and XB the final position of the board, then the displacement of each object can be related by using different frames of reference. The displacement of the person relative to the board is L. The displacement of the person relative to the static frame of reference is XP minus 0. The displacement of the board relative to the static frame of reference is XB minus L over 2. According to the equation for relative motion, we have XP minus 0 is equal to L plus XB minus L over 2. This equation simplifies to XP equals L over 2 plus XB, or XP minus XB equals L over 2. If we now combine this equation with the one from the center of mass, 3 times XP plus XB over 4 equals L over 8, we have a nice system of equations with two unknowns. Therefore, we have XP minus XB equals L over 2, and 3XP plus XB equals L over 2. This simplifies to 4 times XP equals L, or XP equals L over 4. From equation 1, we get XB equals XP minus L over 2. So XB equals L4 minus L over 2, which is equal to negative L over 4. This corresponds to option E.